very bad skin texture. So the only thing that I do down there is only to moisturize it. So my base is actually very, very simple. I use Mila's Acne Treatment Cream. This has worked really well as my base, so I'm gonna use this. I like this as my base. It makes my makeup application really flawless. Helps to control my breakouts. And my next step is actually to use Tarte Rainforest of the Sea. I just love this on the skin. This is an additional step. You don't really need to do this, but this just makes my foundation application a lot more flawless. Excuse my dark eye circles. I'm a mom and I'm trying to sleep well, but it's an impossible fact. Me with my two boys, forget it. For those of you who are actually suffering from really bad dark eye circles and you have really bad scarring issue or something like that, use this, and it's the orange corrector. Use this and then really like tap it into your skin, let it set for a while. Don't quickly take a foundation and, you know, buff it in. It will just move the product away. So just tap it in with your fingers or with a brush and just let it set. And then once it's set, you can go on with a regular foundation. For me, I'm fine if some of my spots are peeking through. I'd rather look really natural and not cake on the foundation. This is Fenty Beauty foundation. This is my holy grail foundation. I love this so much. And thank goodness it's only $50. Because if it's $70 or $80, it's just gonna break my heart. I'm in the shade 350. Foundation works best on my skin. It really gives me a flawless finish. And I just love this on my skin. If you're oily to combination skin, to me, I usually just moisturize and I just let it be. I don't use any kind of like pore filling primer. Another primer that I really, really like and recommend is by Smashbox, and it's actually the translucent one. It's an oil control primer. I really like that one as well. For me, I prefer to use a flat top kabuki because I don't know, it just applies the foundation well on me. Pumps for me to cover my entire face. Certain areas like here, I do need a lot of a bit more coverage, so I'm gonna go in there. I don't go on full on kicking my face because it doesn't work for my skin type. I'm not against it. Like, people can go full on coverage if they feel comfortable and it works on their skin, but for me it doesn't. So I usually stick to medium coverage. This is ColourPop No Filter Concealer in Golden, and I really, really like the undertone of this. So let's put this here. I wouldn't say that it's totally long lasting, but it works, and I just love the undertone. It's just so good. I prime using the concealer. Corners of the mouth and forehead, because you want to balance out. I'm gonna go in with another concealer as well. This is the Makeup Revolution that a lot of people are going crazy over. They're saying that this is a dupe for the Tarte Shape Tape. I like the finish. This is exactly like Tarte Shape Tape, and it's a little bit lighter, and I'm just gonna go underneath my eye area. I'm using the Real Techniques sponge. Compared to the Beauty Blender, I highly recommend this sponge. It's much more cost-savvy, and you can get two packs for about $26 to $29, and you can get two packs of it. I mean, it's so much better than one Beauty Blender. It works exactly the same as Beauty Blender. going to contour my nose area. I'm using NYX Wonder Stick, the only cream product that I use on my face for contouring. I usually use powder contour to contour my face. Yeah, spots that I have that I did not cake on with my foundation, my concealer is just going to hide some of my spots away. So that's the reason why I don't cake on the foundation. I'm going to use my Laura Mercier powder. I'm almost out. It doesn't emphasize on my pores and I really like it on my skin. So that's the reason why I use this. If you don't have Laura Mercier, just use the banana powder. It works exactly the same. Or if you're on a deeper skin tone side, use the Sacha Buttercup setting powder. But only use translucent powder at your highlighted areas. Don't use Laura Mercier all over your face or Sacha or banana powder all over your face if you are in the medium to deep skin tone, because you end up looking either grey, very ashy or very yellow. See, talking to you guys, I crease already very fast. And I use my sponge to set my concealer. I just love it how the way it melts into my skin, and your sponge has to be a little damp, so remember that. I don't bake underneath my eye area because my eyes around here will get really really dry, so I just pack the powder in and just wipe it away. I forgot to put on some lip balm. NYX, stay matte but not flat. I'll just pop a picture right here. I'm in the shade Cinnamon Spice. It's a little bit darker on me, but I don't mind because it really cancels off that grayness that I have going on. But I don't have it with me right now. I have no idea where did I put that powder. I'm trying to find it for the past half an hour, but I cannot even find it at all. I'm going to use the NYX Highlight and Contour Pro Palette. And this is what I would recommend you guys if you're going like everyday office makeup look and you want to look really, really simple. Just take the contour shades like this one. Up to you, your preference on what shade you can use. You can use a lot, as you can see over here. And this is gonna bring some warmth to my crease. And you don't need an eyeshadow palette, just use your contour palette. It's the same shade, and I contour my nose just slightly. Please don't use too much, you're gonna end up looking like a zebra. This shade over here around my lid space. And just to brighten up my lid space a little bit, I like my inner colors. I use this one over here. It's quite shimmery. I just use this and, you know, it really helps to bring out my eye shape. I'm going to curl my lashes. I'm not going to pop on any lashes today because I'm just plain lazy. Mascara, I'm using Yonique mascara. I love this mascara so much because it just helps to lengthen your lashes and it looks so good. For my eyebrows, I'm using ColourPop Banging Brunette. I had like a mirror here and I till now have not gotten any table to put in front of me. So I have like a mirror here. This area out, you don't want boxy eyebrows, so leave this area out and just fill from here to here like sparse eyebrow. Just use this motion of go according to how your hair growth is and then fill in your eyebrows. Don't go super thick here, please don't go super thick over here, it doesn't look natural at all. This NYX Sweet Cheeks palette. These pigments are very light, they are not very pigmented. So if you are someone who doesn't like to cake on the blush, you will like this palette. Now for the favorite part, and that is to highlight. This is Maybelline Master Chrome and it's in molten gold. Oh, I love this so much and it's super affordable. I try to use a lot of affordable makeup for today. So these things you can definitely get this look that I have going on my face in a much more affordable rate. I love this highlighter. It's more like a sheen rather than a very glittery highlighter. If you have very textured skin around your cheeks, don't highlight them. What the hell? Contour, I'm using the same NYX highlighting palette. I just like it after I do my blush. Blend the highlight together with the blusher and the blusher together with the contour. Please don't leave everything very streaky. You're gonna end up looking really terrible. For my lips, I'm going to use this too. This is Maybelline Superstay Matte Ink in 15. And this is NYX Liquid Suede in 04. These two together is like a powerful combo that's going to last you a long, long time. Liquid Suede. Packaging for this has changed. Thank goodness it has changed, but previously it was white and it was disgusting. Urban Decay All Nighter Spray, one of my favorite sprays. This is going to help you take that powder effect away and it's going to bring all your makeup together. So a setting spray is a must. Don't talk, don't smile, don't do anything. Just let it dry. This is how usually I do my base. So that's about it. This is my base. Thank you so much for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe, which is this button over here. Please do give me your support by clicking on the subscribe button. I'll see you guys soon in the next one. Bye-bye.